Greetings. Let's hear what Deedat has to say.
Jesus Christ. In his second coming, we believe that he's coming again. What for? We are told in the Gospel of St. Matthew why he's going to come again. He says, on that day, many will say to me on that day, when he's coming, second coming, say, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name do many mighty works? Didn't we do all these things in your name? We built hospitals, colleges, universities. We looked after the poor. Didn't we do all these things in your name? And we cast out devils. We healed the sick and the blind and the lepers. Didn't we do it in your name?
Did you hear it? Did you catch it? His first error is to claim Matthew 7:22 is about the second coming.
In the second coming, we believe that he's coming again. What for? We are told in the Gospel of St. Matthew why he's going to come again.
The correct meaning, this verse refers to the last day, or judgment day, not the second coming of Christ. On the last day, we appear before the judge, who is also God. The judge will decide if you enter heaven or depart to suffering. These verses, Matthew 7:21-23, say Jesus is doing exactly that. Jesus will sit as judge on the last day. But Deedat is not done with his errors. His second error is to ignore the context and the message of the context. Matthew 7:21. Not everyone that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that does the will of my Father which is in heaven. Notice, Jesus again calls God my Father. I understand Deedat does not dare to call your attention to that, so he avoids Matthew 7:21. Deedat only wants some words that Jesus said, but not the whole truth. His third error creates a problem by misreading what Jesus said.
Lord, Lord, we did it in your name. Jesus says, then will I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. Get away out of my sight. Forsake. Get away, you rubbish. I don't even know you. I'm asking the Christians, he said, look, why should he tell you foot sack? That's our local term, that means get away. Why would he tell you, get out of my sight, when you did all these things in his name? He's not going to tell the Hindus, get away foot sack. He's not going to tell the Muslims, get away foot sack. He's not going to tell the Jews, get away foot sack. But he's going to tell you, the Christian, those who say, Lord, Lord. I say, I want to know why. Why would he tell you foot sack? Answer that, and no answer for them.
The problem is, Deedat is attempting to claim Jesus returns on a mission to reject all Christians. He says this is why Jesus returns. Let's look how Jesus quantifies the people. In verse 21, not everyone that saith. In 22, many will say to me, not everyone that saith. Not everyone means that you cannot say every. It means there is at least one exception. So if even one person fails the test, it is proper to say not everyone. Verse 22, many will say. The word many is not even typical of a majority. On the relative spectrum, from all to none, you have all or every, you have most, you have half, you have many, you have some, few, and you have none. I'm sure there are other descriptors, but many does not even describe an absolute number. It typically does not mean more than half. If it was more than half, you would say a majority or most. So Deedat's third error is to be blind that only some or a few are rejected. Deedat's fourth error is to think they are rejected for saying, Lord, Lord.
I'm asking the Christians. He said, look, why should he tell you fruit sack? That's our local term. That means get away. Why would he tell you, get out of my sight, when you did all these things in his name? He's not going to tell the Hindus, get away, foot sack. He's not going to tell the Muslims, get away, foot sack. He's not going to tell the Jews, get away, foot sack. But he's going to tell you, the Christian, those who say, Lord, Lord. I say, I want to know why. Why would he tell you, foot sack? Answer that. And no answer for that. Why would he tell you? Not the Jews, not the Hindus, not the Muslims, but you, his followers, and who have done this miracles, you have worked miracles, and he's going to tell you, get out. So I said, he's coming to do a certain job of work.
But Jesus said, who would enter? He that does the will of my Father, which is in heaven. So of the people who say, Lord, Lord, those who say, Lord, Lord, and do the will of my Father, which is in heaven, they will enter into heaven. You have to say, Lord, Lord, just to get in the qualifying to get into heaven. Deedat's fifth error is to again overlook that Jesus calls God his Father. In just this short segment, he has made five clear errors. 1. He thinks Matthew 7:21 through 23 is the second coming. It is not. 2. He ignores the context of the verse. 3. He thinks Jesus comes back to reject Christians and only Christians. Wow, that's another thing. I just need to add, that's a sixth mistake. He lumps Islam in with all the pagan religions. Watch this.
I'm asking the Christians. He said, look, why should he tell you foot sack? That's our local term. That means get away. Why would he tell you, get out of my sight, when you did all these things in his name? He's not going to tell the Hindus, get away, foot sack. He's not going to tell the Muslims, get away, foot sack. He's not going to tell the Jews, get away, foot sack. But he's going to tell you, the Christian, those who say, Lord, Lord. Why would he tell you? Not the Jews, not the Hindus, not the Muslims, but you, his followers.
See, he's saying this verse only says Jesus is going to come back and reject Christians, which means he's going to accept, along with Islam, the Buddhists, the Hindus, all of the other pagan religions. 4. He thinks Jesus rejects all who say, Lord, Lord. 5. He ignores that Jesus calls God my Father yet again. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who will sit before you on Judgment Day and will be your judge. Whether you are Muslim, Christian, Hindu, Buddhist, Jewish, you name it, atheist, Jesus Christ will be your judge. And the only way you have a chance of entering heaven is to say, Lord, Lord. And then those who say, Lord, Lord, and do the work of God his Father, they will be saved. Amen.